Yaşadım o deskripte. Okay, there's a few things. Just in case you cannot access the Moodle website still, then there's an error key. Enroll key for the Moodle. It is guidance. Okay. And this is the one thing. I have a few announcements. Second one is the office hour. I set every Thursday from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. Is this office hour is okay for everyone? Does anyone has some conflict with your class schedule or something? No? Okay, fine. So if you decide to come to this office hour, you don't need to make any appointment. Just come to the office, then you can meet me. My office is James Watt South, 7th level, 703C. But if you want to see me out of this office hour, then you better send me an email to make an appointment. Okay, then I'll tell you when you can see me. What else? Yes. Maybe this is the most. Oops. Why is this happening? Assessment of this class is very simple. 80%. Final exam. And 20% term project. Term project has several, I remember, four or five small problems you have to work on. I'll explain each problem when we cover the related contents. Okay, I think that's pretty much it. Any questions? Okay, if you have any questions regarding this assessment, especially for the final exam, you can download all this previous exam, including the solution in the Moodle, so you can see how these exams look like. Okay, so now I'm going to start the first class. So in this class, the main problem is I can pose like this. You have a maybe aircraft, so maybe this is a UAV, unmanned aerial vehicle. Or just maybe the mobile robot on the ground. So this may be a mobile robot. Or maybe underground vehicle. How do I draw the submarine? Just like this. Maybe this is the autonomous underwater vehicle. Autonomous underwater vehicle. So, So it could be anything. So we have a initial position. So this is the starting position. Of this autonomous vehicle, and we have some destination here. So we want to design a path. Basically, we design the path how to design this path for this autonomous vehicle in this class. So from starting point to the destination point, how we can plan the path of this vehicle. But of course, if there's nothing else, you can just design straight line joining these two points is the obvious choice, because that would be give you the shortest path. But what if we have some obstacles like, some buildings maybe. So you have to avoid this building. Or maybe some mountains, so you cannot really climb. Or this is all stationary obstacles, but maybe there's moving obstacles. Maybe there's a car, so you have to avoid this car to avoid the collision. And maybe this place is not that friendly place. Maybe there's some. There's some radar co-located with this SAM, which is surface-to-air missile. So maybe you want to shoot down if the UAV while flying over this place. So you have to avoid a lot of things to safely arrive this destination. Then the question is how to design this path from here to there. Also, there's another issues. This is the autonomous vehicle, so there's no pilot or human inside. So you cannot really immediately identify whether this is an obstacle or not. So you need some kind of algorithm to distinguish this is really obstacles I have to avoid and this is not an obstacle. So you may have some kind of image processing algorithm running on the vehicle. Then whenever this identification algorithm is running, then there is a problem that the identification is not perfect. So you may think that this is obstacle, but this is not really obstacle. So algorithm says that algorithm says that there's a building here, but it's not really there's a building. Maybe some force identification. So this is call it force positive identification. On the other hand, there is really an object, but the algorithm thinks it's not really object. For example, maybe it thinks that this is not really object. This is the, now you have a force negative identification. Not only that, maybe there's also maybe UAV while flying, there may be some strong wind coming from maybe here, this direction. So somehow aircraft deviate from the planned path. And how can we deal with this? So this is the wind. Maybe in more general term, you can say this is the external disturbance. So these are the all kinds of things happening when you're dealing with this path planning problem. But we want to make this problem, this is the full problem, right? Also, this path you should plan in the three-dimensional space, because the vehicles are moving in the three-dimensional space. But to make the problem simpler, we only dealing with, in this class, we don't, we assume that our identification algorithm is perfect. So we don't have this kind of false positive or false negative identification problem. And also we assume that we don't have any moving object. We only dealing with a static object. And we don't dealing with this disturbance problem. We assume that there's no disturbance. And what else? We only dealing with the 2D problem, not the three-dimensional problem. So we embedded everything on the two-dimensional space. But still, this problem is getting quite complicated. Also, this problem is practical. If you can solve this problem, you can actually use in actual situation. So we are interested in the 2D path planning problem. This is what we're going to study with a static obstacle. So we basically approach this problem in two different aspects. We're dealing with each aspect one by one, but let me introduce what are they. First one is continuous problem. So again, here's the starting point, and here's the destination. And we have obstacles here, there, there, over here, yeah. Then we want to design some path from here to there, like this. We want to make a problem quite simple. So, as I said, this is two-dimensional problem. We always need coordinates whenever we set this problem. So you can set coordinates here. So this is x, this is y, and this is your origin. Because it's a two-dimensional problem, you can now derive the equation for this vehicle. Like, for example, x is the x coordinate, x dot is the velocity in the x direction, right? I presume that you are familiar with this notation. This dot notation means derivative by time. So this means basically dx by dt, time derivative of time. So x dot is the velocity in x direction. Similarly, y dot is velocity in y direction. Okay. Then next, we can take a derivative one more time of this each state. So take derivative of velocity. It gives you acceleration in x direction. And of course, time derivative of velocity in y direction gives you acceleration in y direction. The reason because I'm taking the derivative two times to get this acceleration is because acceleration is related to the force. Force is usually we can generate from the actuator. Agree? Everyone agree? Yes. So you may think that this is maybe force in x direction divided by, say, that mass of this vehicle. And this is force in y direction divided by mass. So then the question is that now problem is that you have to design this force in x direction and y direction. So this is your design parameters. Yes? Oh, all right. Okay. So now you can, once you design this force in x direction and y direction, then you just give the command to the actuator, then the vehicle will follow the path you designed. Only question is that now how can we design this force command or equivalently acceleration command? Okay, that's the main question. So of course that to design this, we need something to do with it. So that's it. So that's why we usually set some function. Let's call it some function j. Usually use the symbol j. This is called cost function. There's a variety of things that you can set up. So for example, depending on the situation, if you set j as, for example, from integration, from the starting point, I don't know, starting point, let me give you the coordinate. So starting point coordinate is x0 and y0, and destination is xd, yd. So this is your coordinates. You can set up a cost function. It's integration of from the starting point x0, y0 to xd, yd. And just you integrate just constant 1. Oops. Constant 1 by dt. Let me. Okay. So what do you think this quantity is? What this physical quantity is if you integrate from the starting point to the end point? Just the constant 1. What would be the physical quantity? Huh? Yeah? No, it's not. It's not time. Oh, sorry. I should. It's not dt. Sorry. Yes, you're right. Sorry. Time. It's time. Yes. Okay. So this doesn't make sense. Okay. Yes, you're right. So this is different. I thought completely differently. So okay, this is time. Yes, this is total time, right? From the starting point when you start and when you arrive. So this is the time measured. Yes, you're right. So this is the if you somehow, so this is the total time. Total time length. Total time length. So if you somehow like this, let's say if you design acceleration command, ax and ay, or equivalently fx and fy, force in x direction and y direction. If you design this such that, let's call this is J1. I'm going to introduce the different cost function later. So such that J1 is minimized. Yeah? We don't know yet how to minimize J1 using AX and AY, but let's say we know how to do that, right? Then if you design this, generate this acceleration command such that this J1 is minimized, then you have some AX, some function of maybe time, and AY, maybe some another function of time. So this kind of solution you may get. So this is basically, we call it time-optimal solution. Okay. You can do the similar things as well. Choose different cost function, like say J2, same integration. From the starting point to the destination. Of course, again, the constant L, constant 1, but let's say integration by DL. DL is this is the line integral along this path. This is DL. So then, what is J2 could be? The physical quantity of this? Yes, so this is the distance. Distance between starting point and destination. Again, you can solve different problems. Design, same thing. Design acceleration in x and y such that J2 is minimized. Then this gives you shortest path solution. What else we could have different? So it depends on the each situation. In each different mission, you may want to minimize the time, or you may want to minimize the distance, or you may want to minimize something in the middle. So how can you do that? The easiest way is easiest thing is maybe J3 is the combination of J1 and J2 with some weighted balance. Let's say I can give the lambda times J1 plus 1 minus lambda times J2. And lambda could be some number you can pick between 0 and 1. If lambda is 0, then J3 is equal to J2. So this is the shortest path problem. If lambda is equal to 1, then J3 is equal to J1, then it's the time-optimal problem. If lambda is between 0 and 1, some value, you can pick, then this is some kind of balance between the shortest path and the time-optimal solution. So cost function is really depending on your mission. So you have to choose cost function wisely. But once we are not going to dealing with how to choose cost function in this class. We just assume that this is our cost function and how to design this acceleration in AX and AY command. That's what we're dealing with. But the cost how to choose the cost function is a quite important issue in practice. But most of the time, quite frequently, it's quite obvious. We usually, physically, we want to sometimes time optimal or shortest path either way, or something in the middle. So this, then we're going back to this original picture. So we have to solve this. Let me write down formally. So this problem becomes like this. Minimize J, which is the cost function, either time optimal or shortest path or something in the middle, using what? The command design parameters, which is acceleration in X and acceleration in Y, this direction. We want to do this, and then this is not like finding the minimum point of the function, because we have some governing equation, which is we want to minimize this, but this is subject to the following four differential equations, which we just have, which is x dot equal to bx, y dot is equal to by, bx dot is equal to ax, by dot is equal to ay, and what else we have? What condition we would have? Initial condition and final condition. Yeah. So which is initial condition, we need, this is four-dimensional differential equation, so initial condition and final condition each are the four-dimensional space. So initial condition, for example, is given by starting point, x0, y0, and I didn't say anything about the velocity yet, but maybe we have an initial velocity in vx time is 0, maybe that's just starting from the resting state. So our initial velocity may be 0, 0 and 0. And the final condition, we know the destination coordinates and TF is the final time. Maybe this is, maybe, so arrive the velocity with 0. TF is 0. What other condition we could think of? TF, time TF, so the final time TF. This would be unassigned, undetermined if cost function is time optimal problem. Okay, if our cost function choice is J2, I mean, if you pick the final time already, then there's no way to minimize it. If you already assigned that you have to arrive at the final destination at 2 minutes, then TF is 2 minutes. There's no reason to minimize it. But if you don't assign the final time, saying that you just minimize the final time as small as possible. In this case, then that case, TF is undetermined. On the other hand, it could be determined. Say that in this case, maybe you can say TF is 10 minutes. M-I-N-U, 10 minutes. You want to arrive at the final destination in 10 minutes, exactly, while minimizing J3. J3 is the, not, no, no. This was J1, right? Time optimal was J1. And this was path optimal is J2. So while you're minimizing the path length, but you want to arrive at final destination at exactly at 10 minutes. So there are a variety of things you can think of. Another one more important condition is maybe the acceleration, for example, AX, your actuator have some limitation in terms of magnitude to accelerate in, right? It cannot really accelerate infinite length. So it may have a, maybe you have a, only accelerate in x direction maybe 10 meter per sec square, and decelerate only maybe 5 meter per sec square. Similarly, maybe a y direction is more restrictive, so maybe 2 meter per sec square and minus 2 meter per sec square, something like that. So you have to design AX and AY in this range while minimizing the all these above conditions. Or I mean, while satisfying all the above conditions. Any questions so far? So this is the one that we are going to learn this class. Philosophy is, I mean, this is the same for all engineering design. You can design whatever you want. For example, if you want design, if someone says that design path, give me the path from here to there, then you can give any path. Then the question is that if they ask why you give this path, then you need answer. Okay. You can design whatever you want, but you have to have some justification for that design, why you design in this way. This is the one way. I mean, this is probably the way. So we minimize some function, and then we, based on that, we design path. So someone asked that, why you design this path? And because we minimize this path, this function. And of course, that why you choose this cost function, that's a different matter. Anyway, that once you choose the cost function wisely, then we design the command path to minimize that function. But this problem is quite complicated, in fact, even though you can imagine that if you're going back, you can take this part, this fx and fy part could be very complicated. I ignored completely all this physics. For example, if this is the UAV aircraft, there are a lot of forces here, not just actuator forces or thrusters. There are maybe some drag force and some aerodynamic force, which is very mathematically quite complicated to include here. But we don't include that because this is we call it the path planning or the mission planner. Mission planner is not really controller. So we want to make the problem simpler, so that we can design some command. This is basically, this whole course is basically design the command. So once you design the command, say that you design this path based on some minimization problem, then once you design this path and give you the aircraft, then the low level, we call it low level controller, the controller's role is to follow this path, even though there's maybe wind or there may be some unexpected forces or something like that. So maybe once you design this path, and then if actually this vehicle may follow this path, maybe it may deviate. Oops. It may deviate from like this, yeah? But actually, to minimize this deviation, to follow this path as close as possible, that's the different method. This is that's the low level controller. which I'm teaching in the control course. I guess, how many of you to take the control course as well? Okay, yeah. So you will learn how to design this low-level controller. But here we are only considering this command design issues. But still, so I simplified this part a lot because I don't include any complicated dynamics here. But this problem is still quite difficult to solve, especially if you desire to solve this problem real time, not pre-calculated, but then it's a quite difficult problem to solve. So this is all continuous setting, but there's some different setting to overcome these computational difficulties. So, which is instead of solving continuous problem, now we solve discrete problem. Basically, this is the approximation of the continuous problem so that we can solve more efficiently, requiring less computational complexity. Okay, so then how can I discretize the problems? Well, let me just looking at the one of the differential equations. So x dot was equal to vx. Then I can approximate this differentiation by finite difference. Right? So you remember that the definition of differentiation, x t plus delta t minus x of t divided by delta t. If you want to make this delta t goes to approach it to zero, then that's exactly the definition of the x dot. But I'm not going to do that. Just that this is approximately equal to vx. So delta t you can choose. So this delta t, you just choose something. So this is the designer's choice is S or C. Choice doesn't look right. Is it S? I think C. I mean, this is the automatic spelling correction ruins my whole. Yeah, so you can choose something like maybe 1 second or 10 seconds, depending on the problem. Then you multiply delta t both sides, then the problem becomes like this. X t plus delta t is x of t plus vx. Vx, of course, is the time velocity time t multiplied by delta t. More conveniently, because this is the discrete space now, so instead of using the time index t, we frequently use xk plus 1 is xk plus vxk times delta t. Similarly, exactly the same, if you consider y part, you got yk plus 1 is yk plus byk times delta t. Similar, you can get v. Vxk plus 1 is vxk plus axk times delta t. Vyk plus 1 is equal to byk plus ayk times delta t. So now you discretize whole differential equation. So now this is discrete equation. Hmm. Now, if you want to make problem even make it even simpler, for example, what was the axk ax? Okay, so this is from minus 5 to 10. So ax was originally minus from minus 5 to 10. So any value between this, but you can discretize this as well. Say that okay, ak or axk. Axk is the only my choose among three values, minus 5, 0, or 5. Let's add one more, because it's 10, 5, and 10. You can only pick this either one of these three values. Ay as well. Ay was, I think it's 2, okay. So minus 2, smaller than 2, can only choose minus 2, 0, 2. Okay, then because here I have 4 choices, here I have 3 choices. Then the combination would be 4 times 3. So you have 12 choices in terms of control input. Then if this is your starting point, you can calculate the, so this is my x 0, y 0, v x 0, v y 0, my initial condition. Because there are 12 combinations, there will be 12 different updated conditions, right? Because you insert this initial condition to here, here and there, velocity part, and delta t is constant that you choose, then you have different choice of ax and ay, 12 different conditions, 12 different choices. Depending on what value you choose for ax and ay, you will have a different update value. Yeah? Agree? Yes? So then you will have from here to maybe different places can go, will arrive depending on the input value, what acceleration value you choose. And then you can keep doing that for each. So this is kind of a tree growing, but it will grow really fast. So it becomes quite large, so that's the one thing you have to dealing with, how big tree you want to grow. If the tree is too big, then you cannot really handle, because computation speed is really slow down. But so you have to negotiate how much bigger tree I want. Anyway, you can keep growing, and then eventually, maybe if this is the destination, eventually one of the branches will, or some of the branches will arrive destination. Then this whole space is now discretized. Then you can just inspect each path. For example, if you want to minimize the travel distance, you can just adding up this each branch for each path. Then you just pick the minimum length path. Then you design, basically you design the shortest path. Of course, while you spanning these trees, if you end up these obstacles, you shouldn't. You need some kind of algorithm to avoid, don't spanning the trees inside this obstacle. So you have to avoid this. But then once you construct this kind of branches, then you can solve this problem very efficiently. So this is quite practically useful algorithm. Okay. Any question? Okay. I think this is enough for the first class. And I'll see you on Thursday.